Oregon EMS Data System, EMS Agency User Training, Patient Care Reports. In this session, you'll learn how to log in to Oregon's ImageTrend Elite EMS Data System. You'll learn how to start a patient care report, fill it out, validate it, submit it, mark it complete, and view it. This is a hands-on practice session, so we encourage you to shrink this video into one corner of your screen and bring up a web browser so you can follow along. Feel free to pause this video as you follow along. You can access Oregon's ImageTrend Elite system by going to the address shown on the screen. Today we will log in with the guest account, where the user ID is guest and the password is guest00. If you have a hard time remembering that long website address, you can remember imagetrendelite.com/elite with a capital E. If you use that address, it will ask you for an organization ID in addition to your username and password. The organization ID is Oregon. Now we'll log in with our guest account. The username is guest, and the password is guest00. And now we'll click Sign In. When we sign in, we're asked to agree to the data privacy statement. This reminds us that the information in this system is confidential. After we accept the data privacy statement, we're logged in. There are two ways to fill out patient care reports in ImageTrend Elite. Today we will use ImageTrend Elite Field. The advantage of ImageTrend Elite Field is that it can be accessed while you're offline without a connection to the internet. To get to ImageTrend Elite Field, go to the Incidents menu and then choose Elite Field Login. This will bring you to the Elite Field login page. We recommend that you bookmark this login page. That way, in the future, you can always access Elite Field even if you don't have an internet connection. We'll log into Elite Field with the same username and password. The username is guest, and the password is guest00. Again, feel free to pause this video so that you can follow along and log in yourself. Now we're logged in to ImageTrend Elite Field. If you're going to use Elite Field throughout a shift, you might want to set up your crew, unit, and shift information on the left-hand side. If you do so, then every patient care report that you fill out during that shift will have that information filled in for you. We can click here to create a new incident report, or we can click the drop-down arrow that says Other Forms on the right-hand side to see that there are multiple templates we could use to fill out a patient care report. The standard template, system-wide, is EMS Oregon. That template contains all of the data elements that are required in the state of Oregon. The second template is EMS Oregon Plus. It contains some additional data elements that are useful to many EMS agencies. And the third form is EMS Oregon Non-Transport. That form should be used by non-transporting agencies, and it contains fewer data elements because some elements don't apply when there's not a transport. You can check with your EMS agency administrator. They may have a particular template that they'd like you to use within your agency. Today, we'll use the standard EMS Oregon template for our new incident. This is the data entry screen for a patient care report. We're going to walk through some sections of this report to point out features that you should be aware of in the ImageTrend Elite system. We won't touch every single page and every single data element, but feel free, again, to pause this video as you go and get familiar with the system. Let's start by recording an incident number. You'll see that this is highlighted in red right now, and if I click on the red exclamation point, I get a message that tells me that incident numbers need to be recorded on patient care reports. So I'll go ahead and type in an incident number. And once I've done so, that red message goes away. I would fill out the rest of this screen and then move on to the next screen, which is the unit, where I can select the vehicle, unit call sign, primary role, and level of care of this unit, as well as whether or not this was the first EMS unit to arrive on the scene. Next, I can go to the crew section and add crew members. I can click the Add button, select a crew member, select their level, and select their roles. I can select multiple roles for one crew member. When I click OK, that crew member is added to my call, and I can click Add again to put more crew members on the call. The times area is a very important section of your patient care report. You should fill out all of the times that are pertinent and available to you for your call. For this report, we're going to start with the unit notified by dispatch date time. I can use some shortcuts on the left-hand side to fill out that time. I can click Current to set it to the current date and time. And then I can adjust it using these buttons on the left-hand side. I'm going to go ahead and adjust it to 12 o'clock noon. I'm going to skip the rest of these times for now, but I'm going to fill out my back in service time. Now I can also just type in the date and time as well. And I'll say that I was back in service at 1300. Next, I'm going to skip to the scene section. As I fill out my incident location, I will put in the street address and then a zip code. And based on the zip code, the system will automatically fill in the city, county, state, and country of my incident location. I'll type in the zip code and click Set from Zip Code. And this will give me all of the cities and counties that are covered by that particular zip code. I'll choose Amity. And you can see that the city, county, state, and country have been filled out for me. Of course, I would put in my street address as well. Next, I'll go to the scene section. One of the most important data elements on a patient care report is the incident patient disposition. This was the outcome of the call, whether you treated a patient, whether you transported that patient. The reason this element is so important is because it drives a lot of logic in the run form. The run form will hide or show data elements based on your response to other data elements. Let's see how this works. I can whittle down this list by typing in something. And I'm going to pick patient treated, transported by this EMS unit. That's the most common disposition for an EMS call by a transporting EMS agency. As I select that option, you'll see that many additional sections were added to my patient care report. That's because now the system knows that there was a patient, that the patient was treated, and that the patient was transported. So it asks for additional information based on knowing that. If I were to report a canceled call, on the other hand, many elements would be removed from my patient care report because only a few things apply on a canceled call. Next, let's move to the patient section. I can type in the patient's name and demographic information here, or I can use the Lookup Repeat Patient feature. If my agency has previously responded to this same patient, I can type in their first name, last name, and date of birth to search for that patient. If the system finds a match, I can select it from a list, and it will pull that patient's demographic information as well as their medical history into my patient care report. For now, I'll skip this, and I'll just type in the patient's name. I would continue filling out more information about the patient, including their home address, their condition, and their medical history. Next, I can move on to patient assessment. I can add chief complaint and secondary complaints, and then I can record symptoms and my primary and secondary impression. Next, I move to activities, and this is where a lot of the action happens on an EMS call. I can record the protocols that I used, the exams that I performed, the vital signs that I obtained, the procedures that I performed, and the medications that I gave on the call. Let's look at one of those. If I click on vital signs, I can click add to add a set of vital signs. And I get a form that looks like this, and I can run through this form and fill out the vital signs that I collected. Another option is on the right-hand side of the screen. If I click vitals on this side of the screen, I get a data entry area with a different look, but it's the same information that I'm filling out about a set of vital signs that I obtained on a call. So you can use either the vital signs entry on the left or the vital signs entry on the right. It'll both add vital signs to your patient care report, just with a different look and feel, and you can choose which one you like best. Next, I would move on to my narrative and type in my notes about the call. And then move to the transport and transfer section. As I go to the destination slash transfer area, if I treated the patient and transported that patient, and they went to a hospital recognized by the state of Oregon, I can choose that hospital from this list. If I choose the hospital from a list, then as I move on to the destination address area, the location of that hospital has already been filled out for me. There's only a couple sections left on the patient care report now. The outcomes section contains information about emergency department and hospital disposition. Many times, you're filling out a patient care report before the patient has even left the hospital, and so you'll have to skip these elements because they haven't left the hospital yet. However, the state of Oregon is working with hospitals to help them to record patient outcomes, and those get attached to your patient care reports. So the hospital can actually record that information, and then it will make its way back to you and your agency. Lastly, we have the billing section. There's only a couple things asked for on this page, but if your agency performs billing, then your agency may have several additional questions for you to answer in the billing section. So that's a quick tour of the different sections of a patient care report and how to fill it out. If there's a particular data element you're trying to find, you can use the Find Field option in the top left corner. And as you perform a search, it will show matching data elements. And then you can choose one of those data elements, and it will take you to that page so that you can fill out that data element. Next, let's look at validation. In the bottom center area, there's a validation button. If I click on that button, I'll get a list of validation issues on this patient care report. Some of these are errors, and others are warnings. If the validation message has a 2 next to it, or if it has a red circle with a slash, it's an error. That means I must fix it before I can submit my patient care report. On the other hand, if it has a 1 on the left-hand side and no red circle with a slash on the right-hand side, it's a warning. I should fix it if I can, but I can still mark the report complete, I can still submit the report, even though that warning message is present. It's important to resolve all of the critical errors in order to submit your patient care report. I can click on a particular error message on the arrow on the right-hand side, and it will take me to that section of the patient care report where I can fill out that information. Don't worry too much about this validation score down here. The important thing is that you've resolved all of the errors and that you've looked through the warnings and resolved as many of those as you can. When I'm finished with this patient care report, I can click Post to submit it to the system. Now, if I click Post on this particular report, I'll get a warning message that tells me that I haven't taken care of all the closed call rules. Those are the errors. Those are the validation issues that must be fixed before I can post my report. If I didn't have any errors, then it would go ahead and post my report to the system and let me know that it has done so. Well, this report is clearly not finished. There's a lot that I still need to fill out. But if I were done filling it out, then I would eventually get to the point where I would change the status and mark it as completed. It's important for every patient care report to eventually be marked completed. That's the signal to the state system that your report is finished and ready to use. Now, you can still make further changes to your report even after it's marked complete. Your agency may use some of the other report statuses as well to flag a report that requires review, or to flag a report that needs to be billed, or to mark a report as having been billed. You can check with your agency administrator on whether to use those other statuses. I can exit this PCR by clicking Close. And it takes me back to the main screen of Elite Field. It shows me the patient care report that I've been working on, as well as any others that I may have been working on. And I can click the arrow on the right-hand side to go back into that patient care report and make further changes. If I need a printable version of the report, I can click the Print button. It will ask me which template I would like to use to print the report. There's only one at the system level. Your agency may have some other templates. So I'll go ahead and click Oregon EMS Patient Care Report. And this will bring up a printable view of my patient care report. I'm going to close back out of this report. And I'm going to return to the main ImageTrend Elite site. So ImageTrendElite.com/elite with a capital E. Let's look at one more thing in the ImageTrend Elite main site. And that's how to get back to patient care reports that you've completed in the past. Let's log in. Our organization ID is Oregon. Our user ID is guest, and our password is guest00. To access patient care reports from the past, I can go to the Incidents menu and choose to view existing EMS reports. When I do so, ImageTrend Elite will show me a list of patient care reports that I have access to. As the training guest, I have access to just these two reports because I was a crew member on these calls. From here, I can choose to edit a report by clicking the right arrow on the right-hand side. Or if I've highlighted that report by clicking on it, I can choose bulk actions and create a print report to get the printable version of that report. I can select more than one patient care report if I want to print multiple reports at the same time. Thanks for viewing this demonstration of how to create patient care reports in Oregon's ImageTrend Elite data system. If you have questions or want more information, you can use the contact information listed on this screen.